creativity is the attraction at the Imagine RIT Festival.
It's going to be a great event. The festival this Saturday showcases student innovation with demonstrations and hands-on exhibits. Norma Holland live at RIT giving us a preview. Hey, Norma.
Hey guys, yeah, we've shown you all sorts of things this morning, and that's what RIT, Imagine RIT, is all about. This is Barry Culhane. He's the chairman of Imagine RIT. It's Saturday from 10 to 5 here on campus. And Barry, we were talking earlier, and you said you really should have a plan before you come to this festival because there's so much to see.
Even I can't see everything that's happening. Over 400 exhibits, 2,200 students, faculty, and staff across the whole campus. So if you go to the website, rit.edu/imagine, and hit plan your day, you can get into this program and look at all 400 exhibits, pick out the ones you want, and then it'll print out a little map for you to get around campus.
Great, so you can have a personalized map.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Whatever your interests are. If it's art and imaging, you'll go one direction. Mm-hmm. If it's engineering and computing, you'll go another and
that's really great to
see what you want.
That's really great for parents who have kids who have specific interests, too, so they can do that. Thank you so much. I like that idea. And again, this is what the brochure looks like.
Yes, that's our program.
And there's a whole lot in it, so this is not light reading, but
no.
Thank you so much, Barry. We appreciate it. One of the things you're going to see, is, as we said, is just a varied interest, art, music, dance, you name it. This is really cool. You guys saw the movie Avatar, right? If you haven't, I'm sure people who are watching have. Okay, so this is Alan Gesick, and Alan is a student here, along with, I'm sorry, your name again is?
Dr. Caroline Easton, a psychologist.
Okay, so tell me about this guy here. This is Al-Virt. He is a virtual coach, right?
Correct, yeah.
Okay.
He's supposed to, at Imagine RIT, teach about bullying and how to cope with bullying for younger audiences.
Can you get him started for us so we can see what he looks like? But basically, Al is his name. He will help students and coach them. That's the idea, right? I mean, this gives students and conceivably anyone who needs a coach access to a person or an avatar, if you will, that does the talking, right?
Yes, it's based on social learning theory. Watch a healthy behavior and model a healthy behavior as opposed to a lot of violence that's out there in the different games and on TV. This is to help prevent prevent bullying and aggressive behavior by showing how kindness matters and how to communicate in healthier ways.
So he's modeling it for the participant, right?
Correct, yes.
Okay. He was actually used for another reason, wasn't he?
For substance abuse and domestic violence. It was to how to cope with that, yeah.
So his applications really are seemingly endless, right?
Yeah, it could go pretty much anywhere and anything.
Yeah, and that helps people who perhaps are confined to a location, they don't have access to perhaps a specialist like Al, if you will, in real life, so you can use him.
Yes, correct, yeah.
Okay, I love it. Al-Virt, you're going to see him this weekend. Thank you both so very much.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. And here's another cool thing. They got here early this morning, this group here. You saw the students with the Power Wheels. Well, this is another version of that. And these students are going to be taking part in the race on Saturday morning, right? There's a race with these vehicles. What's your name?
My name's Corey Crace.
Okay, Corey?
Yes.
Okay, Corey, what kind of vehicle is this? And well, are you going to win Saturday?
We're hoping to. I think we got some good designs. This is actually a police charger. It's the Dodge Charger. It's a police interceptor.
Uh-huh.
And we've modified it in a number of ways to try and reduce friction and increase all of our efficiency.
It's electric, right? It's an electric vehicle?
Yes, it's run off of two 12-volt, 18-amp-hour batteries.
Yeah.
And it's fully electric. There's no regenerative power allowed.
In the race itself?
Yes.
So you have to charge up once, and then you just spend your battery. You just drain the battery.
We will be on a track in the center of campus, and the challenge is to do as many laps as possible.
Can someone get in this
hour
while we're talking? I'd love to see someone get in it. So let's see. Mm-hmm. You got to be small enough to do that, and clearly that is not me. So we'll let one of the other students get in there. And again, how fast does this thing go?
We're hoping.
Is this street legal?
Yes, I believe so. We'll have to put the license plates on. But I think it should get up to, 10 to 12 miles an hour.
Woo, you don't say. No. That's kind of a little fast there, my friend. That's wind whipping through your hair fast. You got to be careful.
Right.
Again, the technology that you're using here is applicable in other places, right?
Yes, it is. Basically, what we've done and kind of the main difference of our car is that we've taken bike components and implemented it on our Power Wheels vehicle. So as you can see, there's toddler bike tires on the car. We used a support frame from the toddler bike tire.
Mm-hmm.
And we also we salvaged a mountain bike and we've put different components on it with that too.
This is why you guys are students at RIT, because this is what you do. Again, it's Imagine RIT, and imagine this vehicle Saturday morning is whipping, well, not really whipping around a track, but racing against how many other vehicles?
Supposedly there's 10 people or 10 teams in the race, okay, from different colleges, right, around campus.
Good. Again, good luck, guys. You guys have done an awesome job, and this thing is amazing. You really need to slow down, young lady. You should be careful. Do you have a license to ride this vehicle? Are you sure? Do you have a license for this?
Yes.
Okay. Pull over, please. I need to see your license and registration. We can't have this thing on the road. I hope you... It's a police car, so she wouldn't get pulled over, right? Again, if you're interested in getting more information, rit.edu. It's Saturday from 10 to 5. So much to see, so plan out your day and have fun. And we'll have some more coming up later on Rochester CW. Back to you.